Hi, I am Noel de Asis, and this is part 2 of Wetland Park. And I am in front of the parking lot and where the nature center is. And I will pass on the side of this restroom heading to the West Pond location. In this video, you can see many turtles of different sizes coming out of the water, with some have moss that grew and covered their shells. The dramatic feeding of the moon hen to its youngs. A pair of geese enjoying the pond. A beautiful neighborhood park in the wetlands, Loop Trailhead, where it has many creative animals designs. Playground that the kids would surely enjoy. Strangely, you can see here salt too. Trails, boardwalks, and what you can see in the park's nightlife, and more. So please watch up to the end. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. I thought salt is produced only by using the seawater and let it dry up and the white crystals formed are the salts. But here in the information board, this wetland park soils produces salt. With the water table close to the surface, water is more available, but it can also evaporate more easily, and when that happens, minerals and salts are left behind in the soil. So as we go along in this video, you will notice that strange white crust on the surface of the soil, and it is actually salt. Seasonally and after rains, water evaporates from the ground and leaves behind salt at the surface. When it dries, it forms a crust. So plants that grow here are good at handling salt, that is why they survive. This route is heading to the West Pond, but first passing the boardwalk. But it is closed for the meantime for maintenance. But at the side, I will show some scenes and views. This is the view of the boardwalk. This is a wonderful scene of the moon hen feeding its youngs. As it gives food, it goes away and looks for food again. And it comes back as soon as it gets something to feed. Animals are lovely to watch when they take care of their offsprings. Thank you. Along this route, I see big tall trees look like they were burned some months or years ago. Check what I can see here. Oh, there's a bird's nest. Also, spider's web. Oh, I'll be careful, the spiders are dangerous. And this water is part of the west upper pan, but I will go to the other side to see the whole pan. Are you ready? Let's go! Oh, now this is the west upper pan, and wow, look at that, I can see turtles, so many turtles. Big and small, they're floating on the water. I can see some which have moss on their shells. An American cot is grooming itself with some turtles on its sides, relaxing, enjoying the sunshine and drying up, with two geese enjoying the waters. Then going back. Then I will take this route. This will lead me to the neighborhood park. And if you see at the side of this road, you can see white things that are still salt. A shed, a protection from the sun when you have walked a long way and you can relax here for a while. This information board shows the wetland night's life. After the sun goes down, nocturnal animals run wild through the night. Bats, rodents, and some larger mammals such as foxes, beavers, raccoons, and owls. I have seen already the coyotes, beavers, and owls here, and it is in my video of the wetland park, part 1.
Watch the northern lights flash. Took a photograph on a Paris street. Have you ever climbed a tall tree? Asked someone for mercy. Gave something away that wasn't free. I don't wanna get a vision of you stuck in my head, because I know that you were meant to be wilder. Another night of television while you're lying in bed. It's slowly gonna be the death of you. Have you ever really lived?
The right route goes to the neighborhood park, and the left goes back to the parking lot, but I'm going to the neighborhood park. This is the neighborhood park, and as I said, this has many creative animal designs that can entertain the kids very well, as they will love it too, as well as for adults to relax and admire the park and surroundings.
Have you ever really lived?
I hope you like this video. Thank you very much for watching. See you soon. Bye.